So let's talk about coreboot toolchain. So coreboot project use very specific toolchain with exact version of software, of GCC, of libraries, of GDB. And this toolchain is built as a part of the project. A coreboot project maintains a couple patches on top of toolchain components. But to be honest, like, you may ask, okay, but in our distribution I can install GCC, GDB, and I have libc, so why I need another toolchain? This is because, first of all, coreboot project want to be independent, and it happened in the past many times that various distributions provide broken toolchains or incompatible toolchains. People that create toolchains in general purpose distributions make a lot of assumptions about how toolchain will be used, and typically they do not consider open source firmware development as a main use case. They typically create toolchains for developing under their distribution. Also, coreboot projects want to give ability to be built on various OSs and distros, including BSD or Cygwin. Also, coreboot supports multiple CPU architectures, which what may be different in comparison to approach of toolchain develop and distributed by Linux distros or various other providers. And because of that, coreboot gives ability to build toolchain. It's mandatory, by the way. It requires quite a lot of time, and because of that, we use Docker to deliver it. To deliver this toolchain and not wait hours for building the toolchain on our computer. So. If you will run make with help, then you will see couple ways of building toolchain. You may build for all CPU architectures. You might build only for 32 bits, for 64 bits, for power, for RISC. It depends what is your target. This procedure, of course, is very time consuming. It may fail because of various reasons. Those toolchains are tested by coreboot projects, but sometimes it happened that there are bugs because someone didn't use that for a long time. And of course, to proceed with that, you best would be to use a Docker container that we deliver, which will be presented on further slides. But first of all, you should have Docker installed and ready to use. Of course, in previous practice exercise, we already used Docker, so I believe everything is in the place and should work.